Have you ever thought if the smart in your smartphone might be a bit too smart? Today, we are pulling back the curtain on a topic that impacts every user. Are we trading away our privacy for convenience? If you have ever questioned the fine balance between enjoying technology and keeping your digital life private, you are at the right place. Welcome to Cyber Simplified, the channel that decodes cybersecurity for everyone. My name is Ujjwal, and let's dive deeper and unravel this digital enigma together. Firstly, let's embark on a journey into the past. Picture a world not so long ago where your conversations were ephemeral, captured only in memory, and letters were your personal matter, sealed away from prying eyes. Your life was for the most part your own private domain. The information about you, your preferences, your habits was largely inaccessible unless you choose to share it. The notion of privacy was straightforward, deeply rooted in physical and tangible elements. But then something transformative happened, the advent of the internet. This groundbreaking technology began to reshape our lives in ways we could never have anticipated, starting a chain reaction that is still in motion today. One of the most significant shifts the internet has brought about is in our understanding and expectations of privacy. As technology has continued to progress at breakneck speed, our perception of what constitutes privacy has drastically morphed. Today, personal information that would have been considered private and closely guarded in the past is now just a few clicks away. Search engines, social media platforms, e-commerce sites, they all thrive on the free flow of information, which invariably includes personal data. This metamorphosis in our privacy landscape hasn't happened overnight. It's been a gradual process, marked by the rise of new technologies, the growing digital economy, and changes in societal norms. From posting a letter in a mailbox to sending an email in seconds, from shopping in a brick and mortar store to buying virtually anything online, every step in this evolution has been about pushing the boundaries of convenience. But each step has also meant shedding a layer of our privacy. The shift has been profound and all-encompassing, and it raises an essential question. As we embrace modern technology and its conveniences, are we letting go of too much of our privacy? Moving on, let's take a moment to look around us. The world we live in today is often called the age of convenience, and rightly so. A vast ecosystem of smart devices is at our disposal, each one promising to make our lives easier and more efficient. There are smartphones that perform an endless array of functions, smart watches that track our health and fitness, and even smart homes that adjust to our preferences for the perfect living environment. These devices do seem like magic, don't they? But have you ever paused to consider what powers this magic? The answer is simple yet unnerving. It's your data. These devices learn from your habits, your preferences, your routines. They know when you wake up, when you usually have your coffee, the music you like, your shopping preferences, and so much more. The more they know about you, the better they can cater to your needs, and the smarter they become. But there is an important aspect we often overlook: the journey of your data. Your data doesn't just reside in your device, it travels from your personal devices to vast global data banks across countries and even continents. Every time you use a smart service, you leave a digital trail, your digital footprint. How does this happen? Most often, it happens without consent, or at least apparent consent. Remember all those terms and conditions you agreed to when setting up your smart device? Those often include permissions for collecting and using your data. But the problem lies in the details. Most of us don't fully understand what we are consenting to. The language is complex, the documents are long, and let's be honest, we are all eager to start using our shiny new gadget. But here is the crux. It's your data, your digital reflection, making its way into the global data stream, where it can be analyzed, processed, stored, and sometimes even sold. And all of this for what? Convenience. This takes back to the question we started with: are we trading away too much of our privacy for the convenience these smart technologies offer? Now, we are delving into the third point, which is at the heart of this discourse, the trade-off. Every interaction with our smart devices involves a subtle transaction, a delicate dance between privacy and convenience. Consider this, when you unlock your phone with your face, the phone is not just recognizing you, it's storing and processing detailed data about your facial features. When you ask your virtual assistant for the weather, it isn't just listening to your question, it's storing your voice data, your location, and perhaps even the time of your query. When your fitness tracker records your heartbeat or steps, it isn't just tracking your fitness, it's collecting data about your health, your activities, your lifestyle. All these snippets of data, when pieced together, paint a rather detailed picture of your life. And all this data doesn't just sit idle, it's used to personalize your experiences, make predictions about your behavior, and sometimes it's even sold to advertisers. But wait, didn't we give our consent for this? Well, not really, or at least not explicitly. While we did agree to the terms and conditions while setting up these services, most of us don't fully comprehend the extent of the data we are giving away, primarily because how complex and tedious these agreements are. Now you might ask, is this trade-off justified? Is the convenience of getting personalized experiences, quick access, and efficient services worth giving away slices of our personal lives? The answer isn't straightforward, and it varies from person to person. But what's undeniable is that this trade-off exists, and it's happening every second with every interaction we have with our smart devices. To fully comprehend the implications of this, let's examine some everyday scenarios. Imagine you're shopping for shoes online. Based on your past searches and purchases, the website shows you a selection of shoes that align with your taste. Convenient, right? But in order to provide that convenience, the website has kept a record of your past activity. This information can be used to build a profile of you, which could then be sold to advertisers. Here's another example, smart home devices. They can adjust the lighting, temperature, and even play your favorite music when you come home. But to do so, they need to monitor your habits continuously, learn your preferences, and in essence, watch you. These are just a few instances. The truth is, every interaction we have with smart technologies involves this trade-off. The key question here is, are we okay with it? And if we are not, what can we do about it? Moving to the fourth point, we are now going to address the elephant in the room, privacy concerns. The landscape of digital privacy is pockmarked with instances of data breaches, cyber attacks, and information misuse. What were once considered industry buzzwords are now very real and very imminent threats to our digital lives. To illustrate the gravity of these threats, let's look at some recent examples of data misuse. Let's consider the infamous Facebook Cambridge Analytica data scandal. Millions of Facebook users' personal data was harvested without consent by Cambridge Analytica and used for political advertising. The impact was global, and the implications were massive. Users' trust in the safety of their data plummeted, and a global conversation about digital privacy was sparked. But it's not just about big corporations. Even smaller players in the digital world are not immune to breaches. Ever heard of data leaks from seemingly harmless applications? Some free-to-play games, budgeting tools, even flashlight apps have been found guilty of covertly collecting data and selling to third parties. Now, with these looming threats, you might wonder, aren't there laws to protect our privacy? The answer is yes, there are, but the extent of their protection varies greatly around the world. Let's take a look at some of these laws. In Europe, for instance, the GDPR sets stringent rules for data collection and uses, with heavy penalties for non-compliance. On the other hand, in the United States, the privacy laws are more sector-specific and fragmented, leading to potential loopholes. In many developing countries, the digital privacy laws are still in their infancy, grappling to keep up with the rapid advancements in technology. Even where strong laws exist, enforcement can be challenging. Tech companies often operate across multiple jurisdictions, making it difficult to hold them accountable. So while privacy laws do provide a certain degree of protection, it's clear that they are not a perfect solution. In many ways, they still resemble mere band-aids on a gaping wound. The reality is, in this fast-paced digital age, privacy laws alone can't keep up with the swift and continual evolution of technology. But it's not all doom and gloom. There are also a number of technological solutions emerging to combat these privacy concerns. Let's explore them in the next section. Progressing to our fifth point, it's time to shed light on the silver lining in this complex narrative of privacy and convenience. Indeed, technology is at the root of the privacy concerns we face, but interestingly, it's also a part of the solution. A wave of technological innovations is emerging, dedicated to strengthening the privacy safeguards in our digital world. Let's start with encryption, a technology that's been with us for a while but continues to evolve and improve. Encryption converts your data into a code that can only be deciphered with the right key. So even if your data gets intercepted or stolen without the correct key, it's a jumble of nonsensical characters. Encryption is now standard in many services like messaging apps, email, and even your smartphone. Next, we have anonymization techniques. These aim to mask or remove personally identifiable information from your data. When done properly, anonymized data can be used for analysis and research without directly linking back to you, providing a balance between utility and privacy. Another promising concept is differential privacy. It's a technique that adds noise or randomness to your data, protecting your privacy without significantly impacting the utility of the data. It allows for meaningful analysis without disclosing specifics about individuals. Tech giants like Apple and Google are already incorporating differential privacy in some of their services. Finally, there's blockchain technology, the backbone of cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin. But the applications of blockchain go beyond cryptocurrencies. Its decentralized, transparent nature can be used to build more secure and private digital services. For instance, decentralized identity solutions on the blockchain can give users control over their own personal data. These innovations are clear indications that the technology community is not turning a blind eye to privacy concerns. Instead, they are actively developing and improving tools to protect our privacy, even as they invent new ways to enhance our convenience. However, it's important to remember that these technological solutions are not a panacea. They are tools, and like any tool, their effectiveness depends on how well we use them. And this brings us to our final point, which is perhaps the most crucial: individual responsibility and awareness. Finally, we are addressing the crucial question of balance. How do we navigate this intricate labyrinth of convenience and privacy? Can we revel in the conveniences that technology provides without compromising our privacy? I believe we can. The key lies in being informed, being aware, and being proactive. Let's delve into some strategies that can help protect your privacy while you enjoy the bounties of technology. The first step is awareness. Make an effort to understand the privacy policies of the services you use. It might seem daunting, but you don't need to understand every legal nuance. Focus on the key points. First, what data is being collected? Second, how is it being used? Third, can it be shared with third parties? The second step is taking control. Make use of the privacy settings available on your devices and applications. These settings can help you manage who has access to your data and how it is used. For example, you can often control location tracking, microphone access, data sharing, and much more. Thirdly, consider using privacy-enhancing tools. Remember the technologies we discussed in the previous section? Some of those are already available for you to use. For instance, consider using encrypted messaging apps, privacy-focused web browsers, or VPN services that anonymize your internet connection. Next, be selective and intentional about the information you share online. Not all services need to know your real name, location, or other personal details. share minimal information and only if necessary. Lastly, it's essential to advocate for transparency and accountability from tech companies. The pressure from informed users can drive companies to design products and services that respect privacy by default and by design. Achieving a balance between convenience and privacy is not just about employing tools and technologies. It's about adopting a new mindset. It's about understanding that while the conveniences of technology are enticing, preserving our privacy is essential. By being aware, informed, and proactive, we can indeed enjoy the best of both worlds. Remember, privacy is not a luxury, it's a right. And in this digital age, it's up to us to assert and protect that right even as we enjoy the conveniences that technology brings us. As we wrap up, it's important to note that the balance between privacy and convenience is a personal and complex issue. I hope this video has given you some food for thought and equipped you to make more informed decisions about your digital life. Thank you for joining Cyber Simplified on this enlightening journey. Stay informed, stay vigilant, and together we can unravel the complexities and simplify the digital landscape. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to Cyber Simplified. And we would love to hear your thoughts on this topic, so please leave a comment below. Until next time, stay safe and keep learning. Thanks for watching.